his continued protection. So let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of God, Heavenly Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, and the life of their Holy Spirit, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Again, we welcome all of you to this private Mass on this third Sunday of Easter. Our readings today are very rich. In our Gospel, we have a very famous story with the disciples on the road to Emmaus, meeting the risen Lord Jesus, and in the breaking of the bread, they discover it is he, and he vanishes from their sight. And Peter, some 50 days later, in our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, on the great feast of Pentecost, witnessed to his experiences of the risen Lord. And many people were cut to the heart and became disciples of Jesus that day. So for just a moment, let us reflect upon these readings, the mysteries that are involved here. We'll ask the Lord's forgiveness in case we've offended him or offended one another. And we ask that his transforming grace be at work in our lives during this Easter season. Lord Jesus, you are the Word of God made flesh. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are both Messiah and King. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the bread of life nourishing us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God in heaven have mercy upon each one of us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
In song, let us offer glory and praise to God.
Thank you.
so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, we pray, for he lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
At this time, we'll have our first reading, which is taken from the New Testament Acts of the Apostles, and it's the message of Peter 50 days after the resurrection of Jesus on the great feast of Pentecost, when he stands up, he witnesses about the resurrection of Jesus.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commanded to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore, my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh, too, will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in your midst to this day. But since he was a prophet, and knew that God had sworn an oath to him, that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus, of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured him forth as you see and hear." The word of the Lord. Beloved, if you invoke as Father him who judges impartially according to each one's works, conduct yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him, believing God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Going on farther.
Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over. So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?" So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We welcome everyone again to our celebration of liturgy on this third Sunday of Easter. We have heard during these challenging times that it's good to have a sense of humor. So I thought I'd start the homily off again tonight with a little bit of humor. These are some one-liners that came to me through friends and parishioners. One of them says this: "If you thought toilet paper shortage was crazy, just wait till 300 people all want a haircut." Could be a problem. Wearing a mask inside your home might be highly recommended, not so much to prevent COVID-19, but to stop eating. Kind of starting to understand why pets try to run out of the house whenever the door opens. My mom always told me that I wouldn't accomplish anything by laying in bed all day. But look at me now, I'm saving the world. I swear my fridge just said, "What do you want now?" And lastly, closing thought is this: remember, no storm lasts forever. Hold on, be brave, have faith. Every storm is passing. A few thoughts as we begin the homily tonight. Our gospel tonight is very famous. It's the gospel of the disciples on the road to Emmaus. And some people see it as being the very first Mass after Jesus' Last Supper. And usually a homily embodies a story, but the gospel itself is a story all by itself. It's the story of two disciples who had high hopes for Jesus. They had just seen him crucified. But in the upper room, they had heard word from the women that the tomb was now empty, and they couldn't find the body. And they were discussing these things on the road to Emmaus, which was about 7 miles distant from Jerusalem. And as they're discussing these events that had happened, this stranger begins to walk along with them. And the Mideast garb of the time would involve a shawl and some sort of wrap around them, so it wasn't necessary to see the person's face. And so they begin to dialogue with this stranger, who asks, "What are you talking about?" And they ask him, "Are you the only one who doesn't know what happened in Jerusalem these last few days?" And so he says, "Explain." And so they begin to discuss, and the stranger begins to talk about the Old Testament, something they were familiar with. And he cites how the Christ, the Anointed One, the Messiah, was mentioned in the Old Testament, in the prophets and in the law, and how the Christ first had to suffer and die and then be raised from the dead. And so you might say that was the liturgy of the word for them. That was the breaking of the scriptures. And then the second part of their experience was they went in to break bread. And in the breaking of the bread and the blessing of the bread, they realized it was their dear friend Jesus. And with them it says he vanished from their sight. And they went on to say, "Were not our hearts burning within us as he spoke to us on the road about the scriptures and how he explained his presence in the Old Testament scriptures?" And so they were so overjoyed, they left the table and ran back to Jerusalem to tell the 11 who were gathered in the upper room of their experience. And they were greeted with the message, "We have seen the risen Lord too. He's appeared to Simon." And if we were to continue reading in Luke's gospel, that chapter 24, we'd hear how Jesus came and stood in their midst that intact with a new body, which we call his glorified body. And so the disciples were very, very much overjoyed. And so this mass experience tonight that we listen to is, in a sense, the first mass celebrated after the Last Supper. We have the sharing of the scriptures, which we call the liturgy of the word, and the breaking of the bread, and we call that the liturgy of the Eucharist. The first mass after Jesus' Passover Last Supper. And as we listen to our first reading, we fast forward in time from this first Easter, we fast forward 50 days to the Feast of Pentecost. And we have Peter and the disciples who have just received an outpouring of the Holy Spirit, and they went out into the street to witness about what they had seen and heard about their experience of the risen Lord Jesus. And that's what we heard tonight in our first reading. Peter witnessing to the people in Jerusalem that they had an encounter with the risen Lord. And so the people who he preached to were so concerned, they said, "What do we have to do to be saved?" And Peter said, "Repent from your sins, believe in the risen Lord Jesus, and receive the Holy Spirit." And with that, the scriptures say, many, many people were added to their number that day. And so, for ourselves in our own day and age, what does all this mean to us? Well, it means, the Easter season is a very special time of year. It's a time when a special grace comes to us, when we too can experience the risen Lord through prayer, through the reading of Scripture, through the Eucharist, and in other ways. The risen Lord wishes to come to us. And the other point we can say is that not only does he want to come to us, but through our efforts, like Peter's, he invites us to witness to others our experience of the risen Lord Jesus. Not that we brag about the experience, but we share our experience of the risen Lord, Jesus, that others may be enriched by the life of Jesus. May these be our thoughts and our prayers today as we celebrate the third Sunday of Easter. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us make our profession of faith at this time, praying the Apostles' Creed, which we pray at the beginning of every rosary. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. With the disciples on the way to Emmaus, let us ask Christ to stay with us a while and answer our prayers. We pray for all who seek truth and for all who guide truth seekers. For them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for civil authorities and for all who work toward the common good. For them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the poor, the unemployed, all who struggle to make ends meet, and those who are adversely affected by the coronavirus, that relief may come to them. For this, we pray to the Lord. We pray for all who try to walk in the way of the Lord, and for all who have strayed from the path. For this, we pray to the Lord. We pray for all who are present at this Mass, and for all who recognize the Lord in one another. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, open our eyes to your Son. Hear our needs and grant what will bring us closer to you. For we ask all these prayers through Christ the risen Lord.
Thank you.
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember, Lord God, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, Robert his assistant, and all the clergy, religious, together with all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters, family members and friends who have already fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who are dying in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Tonight's Mass is offered for all the parishioners of St. Lucy's Parish, those of the past, those of the present, and those who will join us at some time in the future. And we pray in a special way for Frank P. Mickey Mello, for Shania Steele, for the children who have made their first communion this weekend, and also for Raymond F. King and Fred Romanos. So that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, along with the blessed apostles, St. Lucy, our patroness, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we too wish to be worthy to be co-heirs to eternal life, so that we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you." Look not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to one another some expression, some sign of the Lord's peace.
For those who cannot be at Mass to receive our Lord in Holy Eucharist, we offer the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you with my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Our celebration here is now complete. Let us go forth in the peace and the joy of Christ the risen Lord.
Thanks be to God.